Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on how to build a 300 wheel horsepower B48 and the best BMW B48 engine upgrades. Before moving into the best modifications for the BMW B48 engine, just talking about a couple of the basics and a little bit of background information about the BMW B48 and how that affects modifications. There are a number of variants and more than a handful of power output versions of the BMW B48. So the B48 does make anywhere from 154 to 302 horsepower from the factory, and 184 to 332 pound-feet of torque. Pretty large range there. Ultimately, all of the B48 engines will end up at roughly the same end power with these modifications that we'll be discussing throughout the video. And that applies to the 20i and 30i models as well. While the 20i models have a much lower starting point when it comes to power, that is mostly due to the fact that they simply have more conservative tuning and a lot less power from the factory. But mechanically, the engines are similar and will end up in similar ballparks once all of the tuning and modifications are completed. Now, the one thing to point out is that we are excluding the 302 horsepower variant that is found in 35i models. And the reason for that engine does have a number of mechanical changes that do affect modifications much differently than the rest of the B48 engines. It does have a lower compression ratio, a revised intake tract, and a larger turbocharger, so it's naturally going to make a bit more power in stock form and a bit more power when tuned and modified. But just wanted to point out, even though models like the 20i's have much lower starting points, they will still end up in the same roughly 300 wheel horsepower ballpark with these modifications that we discussed throughout the video. Jumping right in, number one off the bat, we have tuning for the B48. A tune alone on the B48 can add about 20 to 40 wheel horsepower. Depends on how aggressive of a tune you go for. Things like stage one tunes are going to be a little bit on the lower end of that ballpark, whereas something like a stage two or a stage two plus tune is going to be on the higher end of the 20 to 40 wheel horsepower gains. And you can even pick up a little bit more with ethanol or E85 fueling, specifically an E30 blend, but we'll circle back to that topic later in the video. But ultimately, 20 to 40 wheel horsepower for a simple tune that's about $500 or $600 makes a tune the single best bang for your buck upgrade for the B48. And not only does it offer excellent power gains for the price, it's also the foundation to maximizing power gains from additional bolt-on modifications that we'll be discussing throughout this video. Multiple benefits to running a tune on the B48 outside of just the big power gains from the tune itself. The Boot Mod 3, or BM3 for short, and JB4 Piggyback Tuner are two of the most popular and best options for tuning the B48. Which route you go generally depends on personal preference. Some people don't like the idea of piggyback tunes like the JB4 and only like flash tunes like Boot Mod 3. Whereas on the other hand, the JB4 can be an awesome tune if you're simply looking to install a tune and a couple basic bolt-ons and not go much further. However, if you are looking for turbo upgrades or larger modifications in the future, then Boot Mod 3 and flash tuning and custom flash tuning might be the better direction to go when it comes to picking a tune for your B48. Moving on to the second best upgrade for the BMW B48, we have an upgraded intake. Just to point out right off the bat, an intake, when it comes to power gains, is going to offer the smallest gains out of all the modifications we talk about on this list. With an upgraded intake on the B48, you can expect to see power gains of roughly 3 to 5 wheel horsepower. With conservative tuning and no other modifications, you might not even see any power gains at all. Whereas on the other hand, if you have a stage two tune and the rest of the bolt-on modifications, then you'll likely see power gains around 3 to 5 wheel horsepower from the addition of an intake. However, the benefit with an intake upgrade is that they are very cheap, talking about $150 to $300 for an upgraded intake. They're super easy to install. They offer awesome turbo and induction noises and clean up the engine bay. We think they look great. So a number of benefits outside of the small power gains when it comes to intake upgrades. One of the least impressive mods when it comes to power and performance gains, but it is super cheap, simple to install, just an easy upgrade in general, and something that we highly recommend. Combining with a tune as your first couple modifications, just knock out the tune and the intake right off the bat, and they're great mods to couple before moving into some of the additional modifications that we discuss on this list. Which, speaking of, at number three here, we have an upgraded downpipe for the B48. Outside of tuning, a downpipe is likely the next best bang for your buck mod. You can expect to see power gains of roughly 5 to 15 wheel horsepower. Generally, more so in the mid-range of that, probably 8 to 12 wheel horsepower is a more realistic ballpark, but power gains can vary quite a bit from a downpipe, and one factor in that is catless versus catted high-flow downpipes. So a catless downpipe is going to show the biggest power and performance gains. However, the downside is you're likely not going to pass any form of a sniff test or visual inspections, since a lack of a catalytic converter will result in an instant fail, and a catted high-flow downpipe will show slightly lower power gains, but has the benefit of it will likely pass any emissions testing, any form of sniff test, and there is a catalytic converter in place on the vehicle and on the downpipe, so that won't be any cause for concern for visual or other forms of emissions inspections or testing. Ultimately, that's a trade-off between the two. A catless downpipe is going to offer slightly better power and performance gains, probably about 2 to 5 wheel horsepower more with the catless option compared to a high-flow catted downpipe. But either one is a great choice and a great upgrade for the BMW B48. Outside of the power gains, you'll also notice faster turbo spool, and reducing back pressure on the engine makes the engine and the turbo's job a lot easier. So ultimately, it's just safer and healthier for the engine to be running an upgraded downpipe and reduce that back pressure, get those hot exhaust gases through the engine and out more efficiently. Downpipe is an excellent upgrade. Again, one of the best bang for your buck mods. And additionally, a downpipe is highly recommended and sometimes required for things like stage 2 or stage 2 plus tuning. Last but not least on the list here, we have ethanol or E85 blends, specifically E30 fueling, as we had mentioned in the tuning section. So running an E30 blend can show power gains of roughly 8 to 15 wheel horsepower. E85 also burns cooler than gasoline and significantly reduces the chance of any engine knock or detonation. So very great upgrade for engine health and safety and picking up 8 to 15 wheel horsepower, especially considering ethanol is just an alternative to 91 or 93 octane premium fuels. Generally, the price of E85 is more in line with lower grade gasoline or even cheaper than that. The B48 can run an E30 blend on the stock fueling system with the appropriate tuning, which the tunes that we discussed, Boot Mod 3 and the JB4, both have options for running an E30 fueling tune. Really, this is a free upgrade that adds, again, about 8 to 15 wheel horsepower. Just fill up on an E30 blend at the pump. You'll even save a little bit of money filling up. However, the trade-off is E85 does require a bit more fuel flow, so you will lose a bit of fuel economy, but ultimately this is a free upgrade and is much safer and healthier on the engine. So if you do have access to ethanol conveniently, we highly recommend running it. And that is the one downside though. A lot of parts of the country and some countries don't have easy access to ethanol or E85 fueling. So if you're in that boat, unfortunately, it's one of those modifications you'll likely want to skip over to avoid the inconvenience of having to drive far to fill up on E85 or store it for a couple months at a time if you have to make a long trip to fill up on it. But if you do have access to it, again, we'd highly recommend running an E30 blend and trying that out on the B48. Those are really the four power upgrades on the B48 to take the engine to roughly 300 wheel horsepower. Now, there is one supporting mod to touch on quickly, and that is a charge pipe. This is not a power upgrade by any means. However, the B48 charge pipe does occasionally fail at higher than stock boost. It's not as problematic as some of the older N series engines like the N20 and the N55, but the charge pipe on the B48 does still occasionally fail and crack and require replacement. So if you are looking to do all these mods, we'd highly recommend upgrading to an aluminum charge pipe and just knocking that out for peace of mind and not having to worry about issues down the road. These are really the only modifications on the B48 required to get to roughly the 300 wheel horsepower ballpark. With a tune, intake, downpipe, and an E30 blend, you'll likely end up right in that 290 to 300 wheel horsepower ballpark. and about 315 to 330 wheel torque. And that is about the most or the maximum amount of power that the B48 will support on the stock turbocharger. You can squeeze out a little bit more if you look for additional modifications like water methanol injection, or opt for custom tuning to dial things into your specific vehicle and setup. Maybe 325 wheel horsepower is about the limit on the stock turbo on the B48. So if you are looking to go further than that, then you will have to start looking into turbo upgrades. B48 is a super simple engine to upgrade and modify. It responds very well to these basic bolt-on mods. And 300 wheel horsepower from a little 2-liter inline four with just a couple simple bolt-ons that cost about $1,500 all in is nothing to be ashamed of, and certainly makes the B48 appealing for those reasons. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the video, please hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, and check out the description below for more awesome content. Thanks.